Now let's begin, and in this it is very much important because the topic is quite vast. I have tried to cover it and cut it short to the ones that is so very, very important for examination, as well as I will have added some new things that has a potential to be asked. Okay, now coming to malaria, we all know that the parasite is Plasmodium. What is the vector? Vector is a female anopheles. Okay, so this female anopheles mosquito has a sexual cycle which is in the mosquito and an asexual cycle which is in the man. The intermediate host in malaria is man, which has an asexual cycle. This is also known as cyzygony, and the sexual cycle is also known as sporogony. ठीक है, how does this malaria spread? We all know it spreads by the bite of female anopheles, and the infective form from the female anopheles that comes into us is the sporozoids. Non-sexual form transmission can also happen. I mean, not just through the bite of sporozoids, also they can be, you know, we can also have the non-sexual form transmission in the form of blood transfusion directly from the mother to the child, as well as using IV drug usage. Very important for this parasite and vector are some environmental factors. Supposedly, number first is the temperature. The temperature needs to be suitable both for the vector and the parasite to, you know, build up and in the vector. Okay, the temperature which is suitable for Plasmodium to grow in is 20 to 30 degree. Less than 20 degree it is not conducive, and more than 30 degree it generally doesn't grow. Second is humidity. It requires humidity. First of all, the vector will also increase in number and density, and it will help to, you know, pass on the Plasmodium. Third is also the rainfall. It is seen that with increased rainfall, there will be washing away of the already set places that Anopheles has already, you know, covered. But at the end of the day, it will also lead to formation of pools and lakes in which it can obviously have more density later. Number fourth thing which has to be noted is the height or the altitude as well. It is generally seen that in high altitudes, more than 2000 meters above sea level, they do not grow. I mean, they do not sustain there. It's not conducive for them. Okay, now briefly coming to the life cycle, I don't want to go much into the life cycle. It would be covered in other subjects like, you know, microbiology, etc. But for the completion's sake, I would recommend you guys also to read all about malaria, all about the diseases which we'll be talking about in further classes all at once. It is easier to sink in the knowledge and to corroborate the knowledge together, and it helps in better remembering. Okay, coming to the life cycle first, it has mosquito phase. Mosquito mein kya tha? Sporogony. Aur human mein kya tha? Cyzygony. Okay, now in humans, what is the infective stage? The infective stage, it comes through the sporozoid. The sporozoid enters, goes into the liver before the... And then it goes to the RBCs. In the RBCs, there is an erythrocytic cycle. In liver, this is exoerythrocytic cycle. In the liver cells, they become infected and leads to the production of cyzons. These cyzons then rupture and release merozoids. Okay, then these can either affect now the RBCs. Now they will affect the RBCs. These RBCs will go and they will form trophozoids. Immature and then mature and then into cyzon, and which will then rupture. Okay, either it can go through this cycle of thing, or it can either form into gametocytes. They can be the male and female gametocytes, and then if these gametocytes are taken by the mosquito will be infected, and within the mosquito, the female gametocyte will convert into the macrogametocyte. The male gametocyte will get convert into microgamete. It will get a tail also attached to it, and then it will infect the macrogametocyte, and then they will fertilize, and then it will formation of an zygote, or which is also known as oocyanate. This oocyanate will then convert into oocyst, and then this it will rupture and release of sporozoids. So the release of sporozoids and it has to go to the saliva of the mosquito for it to infect us. Okay, and where does all these things, oocyte and oocyanate, takes place? In the stomach wall as well. Okay, clear. Now let's proceed to the next slide. Okay, now we are talking about the vector. The vector here is anopheles. Obviously it is a female anopheles. The vector these are the types of the vector and what kind of malaria it causes. Also, I have added a column of remarks for us to remember the special type. Culicifaces causes rural. Easy thing is culi, kali, rural. Theek hai? Gaon mein kale log. Okay, I don't want to be racist here. Let's proceed. Stephen C. Urban. St. Stephen's College, St. Stephen's Hospital is in urban area of Delhi. It helps us to remember. Okay. Fluvia tellus is in forest, okay, hilly areas of forest, fluvia tellus. Sundaicus in Sundarban, Sundaicus in brackish water, okay. Dirus, Minimus eroticus, these are mostly in northeast. Minimus is also in northeast, and eroticus is in Andaman and Nicobar Island, okay. Mostly Andaman and Nicobar Island, people go for honeymoon. Okay, clear. So we now can remember this. Culicifaces is rural, Stephensi is urban. Now in culicifaces also there are species A and species B. Basically species A is a major one which affects the humans, and it carries both vivax and falciparum. But it is noted that species B, that P. falciparum, where cattle density is low, it only infects then. Okay, urban malaria mostly, you know, where it can be open spaces and overhead tanks. Fluvia tellus in moving water, in the hills, forest. Sundaicus in the brackish water. Okay, now we know the type of vectors that are responsible for malaria. Okay, culicifaces is the main vector. What are its feeding habits? Basically, it is zoophilic. That it is not just anthrophilic, it is zoophilic also. It, you know, infects cattle, other things also. High density. Resting habits, rest during daytime in cattle sheds as well as in human dwellings. The breeding places are rainwater pools and puddles. Basically lakes, you can remember, and it has an extensive breeding encounter during the monsoon rains. Culicifaces is in rural, so rural mein hi lakes hoga, pools hoga, puddles hoga, obviously more rice fields. It's also, what is endophily? This is a potential question. Endophily is that it has a habit of resting inside after a blood meal, so that is known as endophily. What is the biting time? Biting time is basically dusk after evening, okay, and then obviously it will more in winter. What is the lifespan of a mosquito? Generally we say that is 2 weeks or around 15 to 20 days, okay, but then it should be live for at least 10 to 12 days for after an infective blood to become infective. For the life cycle we read just now, from the stomach line it should have gametocyte, and then to convert into sporozoid it would require 10 to 12 days. So this is the anopheles we have been talking about. In the next presentation, where I would be covering dengue and chikungunya, I would be covering about the vectors as well. Okay, these anopheles, what it is, how to identify, I will be talking about then. But for the completion sake, just note that this is how anopheles looks like and how other parasites will look like. I will speak about it later. Just for the attention, just draw attention. It is 45 degree, it has no, you know, marks, etc. And this is how the larva looks like when it is in water. Okay, now the parasite. The parasite is Plasmodium. Okay, now there are four parasites, 1, 2, 3, 4. Vivax, falciparum, malaria and ovale. Now, vivax is in India, it is also the, It is the widest in the world distribution, and incubation is 14 days. For falciparum, it is 12 days. It is 28 again, and then 17. How do you remember this? 14. Se 2 minus kiya 12. 14 se, then into 2 kiya 28. ठीक है एंड प्लस 3 किया तो 17 माइनस इनटू एंड प्लस ठीक है एंड 14 ठीक है एंड मोस्ट कॉमन इज नाउ फैल्सिपेरम बिकॉज 50% इज कॉज ड्यू टू फैल्सिपेरम 4 to 8 इज ड्यू टू मिक्स इन्फेक्शंस एंड रेस्ट बाय द वाइवैक्स ओके सो वी नो द साइकिल कम्स इन 48 आवर्स एंड इन मलेरिया इट कम्स इन 72 आवर्स ओके नाउ ओवेल इज लिटिल रेयर इन इंडिया एंड mostly not seen basically its focus is mostly in the tropical part of Africa and malaria is seen in Karnataka